How fast can you solve this challenging PSLE math question? In this practical math video, we are going to look at a PSLE MCQ math question that got some primary 6 kids stuck doing their exams. So let's take you through the fastest way of solving this, and you can see whether you solve it in the same way too. Are you ready? Let's read this problem together. 1/3 of rod A and 1/8 of rod B is in the ground. We have two rods, and we have two fractions. Let's read the first fraction. What does 1/3 mean? Well, we have 3 as the denominator, and this means that we can divide rod A into 3 equal parts. And when we do that, do you know how many of these parts will be in the ground? To answer that, let's look at the numerator. Since we have 1 on top, we can tell that one of these parts will be in the ground. So far, so good. Now let's take a look at the second fraction. Do you know how to read this now? This time, we have 8 as the denominator. And this means that we can divide rod B into 8 equal parts. And how many of these parts will be in the ground? Yes! Since we have 1 on top of this fraction, we can tell that one of these parts will be in the ground. Are you still with me? But then given that these two rods touch the straight line at the top, and what are we supposed to solve? We need to find the total length of rod A and rod B. So how will you solve this? Well, I hope that you are looking at the diagram in two parts. The part of the rods that are above the ground and the part that are in the ground. What do you see? If you open your big round eyes, I'm sure you notice that the length of the rods that are above the ground happen to be equal, right? So let's see what part of each rod is above the ground. Since we know that 1/3 of rod A is in the ground, this means that 2/3 of rod A must be above it. Agree? And we can find the fraction of rod B that is above the ground using the same logic. If 1/8 of it is in the ground, 7/8 of it must be above the ground. Make sense? And as for the length of the rods that are in the ground, we can see that 1/3 of rod A touches the ground all the way to the end. And 1/8 of rod B is 30 centimeters away from the end. Do you know what's the trick to solving this problem? Well, just like how we make friends, the trick to solving this math problem lies in working with something common. Do you know which part of the rods are the same? If you're thinking about the parts that are above the ground, you're on the right track. And that's exactly what we're going to start with. Here's where the magic happens. We're going to rotate this 90 degrees and then take away all the distracting stuff. When we add in the useful information that we have, does this seem familiar to you? This makes things so much easier. We know that the fraction 2/3 and 7/8 represents the same length of the rod. So instead of working with fractions, let's turn everything into units so that we can compare them easily, okay? Now how can we do that? Do you think of making the numerators the same? If you did, great job. What's the common multiple between 2 and 7? Yes, 14. So 2/3 is the same as 14 over 21, and 7/8 is the same as 14 over 16. Do you get that? Now what can we tell from these fractions? The numerator of each fraction tells us how many parts of each rod are above the ground. Agree? Then what about the denominator? The denominator tells us how many units represent the whole length of each rod. So looking at this fraction over here, we can tell that we can represent the entire length of rod A with 21 units. And how many units can we use to represent the entire length of rod B? Yes, 16 units. Remember that we're asked in the question to find the total length of rod A and rod B. In other words, we want to find how long 21 plus 16, 37 units represent. Here's where we need to find a clue that links the length to a number of units. So can you find any useful information so far? Dang, dang, dang! Remember the 30 centimeters that we have earlier on? When we subtract 16 from 21, we can tell that 5 units represent a length of 30 centimeters. So let's make use of this to find the value of 1 unit. When we divide 30 by 5, we are going to get 6. And once we know that 1 unit represents 6 centimeters, we are just one step away from getting our answer. Let's find how long 37 units represent by multiplying 37 by 6. And my dear boys and girls, we have found that the total length of rod A and rod B is 222 centimeters. Now try solving this PSLE math question on your own and let us know how long you took, alright?